Ways to style your hair to look 10 years younger. Yeah. Hi, you guys. It's Erin. Welcome back to my channel. My mission through my channel, you guys know, you've heard it before. It is to help you look like the best version of yourself. Doesn't just include your style. Also, we talk about beauty sometimes here on Busby Style. I don't know if you know this about me or not, but I absolutely love doing hair. Like, I wish I had more time to really do hair. I wish I had a daughter that didn't have a sensitive scalp who would let me touch her hair, because ironically, I can do every kind of braid known to man and she won't let me touch her hair. But anyway, I love to do hair. It is my jam, but I don't have a lot of time. So usually I come up with ideas that are very fast, quick, easy, but I'm also always thinking about modern looks, youthful looks, but also age appropriate. I don't want to look over the top like I'm trying too hard to look young, but I do want to look more modern and youthful, and I think hair is a big deal, very big deal. I did a whole video about how to make your hair look thicker. It's longer term fixes as well as instant fixes. I will put a link to that video below. It's really good. Make sure you go back and watch that. In this video, I want to talk about specific hairstyles you can try to look younger. This is really geared for those of you with a medium length hair or long length hair. For those of you with shorter hair, it's probably not the video for you. You wanna skip this one. I did do a whole bob styling video with a really short lob. So that could be one that you wanna watch, and I will put a link to that one below. But for this one, you need medium to long length hair. Let's get started. The first transformation that is very simple to do that will make you definitely look sexier and more youthful is, instead of wearing your hair like I am here, stick straight, almost like sticking to the head, what you want to do instead is tease the crown of your hair. Tease your hair around the front. Now, I know some of you will say in the comments like, oh, teasing your hair can cause damage. Yes, that's true. Don't rip your hair out of your head. Do it very gently. It doesn't take much for you to tease your hair and to get some volume that way. So see, the hair's off the face a little bit on this side, side sweep here. We've got an upturn at the ends. Just those little tweaks make the hair look so much more youthful and vibrant and modern, and also it's just more flattering in general. So even if your goal isn't to look more youthful, I think this is definitely like a more flattering style all the way around. And that's really simple to do. You just saw me do it in like 30 seconds. The only thing I would say is that, you know, this is probably not gonna stay. So I would put a little bit of spray, you know, here on the sides just to keep that back. And that's it. So it's worth it to take the little extra time. We're talking about minutes to make it look that much better, that much more youthful, that much more modern, that much sexier. Another really fast, easy option, instead of the stick straight aging hairstyle, let's throw it half up. Half up, really easy to do. Very functional, by the way, keeps your hair out of your face. It's very feminine and pretty. It's such a pretty hairstyle. And again, it'll take you less than 3 minutes to do it. This one is really simple. All I'm gonna do is grab the hair in the front. So I'm just gonna tease right here. Notice I'm not like ripping the hair out of my head. I'm just gently, gently, gently teasing. So if I had two pins, I'd put one pin on one side and one pin on the other just to hold it in place. But since I'm at the studio and I don't have bobby pins, the key here is when you're pulling through, don't pull it so it's so straight, because then you ruin your whole poof. So I'm just going to, but bobby pins will solve this problem too. See, it still feels like it's pulling and it's flat in my poof. So I'm gonna go like this and pull it out and try to make it even. Once I'm happy with the poof and I'm happy with the pony and I'm happy with the sides, I make sure it's flipped up instead of under. And then there's this little trick, and I'll show you this with a bigger ponytail as well, is to take the underneath of my little tiny ponytail. So I'm gonna take one small piece and then wrap it around the ponytail. And then when I get to the end where there's no more hair, I'm going to tuck that into the hair tie. Ideally, I tuck it in underneath. So not on the top, underneath. So it creates this really cool effect, covering that ponytail with your own hair. It's this little detail, a little effect, looks really chic, looks really polished. It looks very deliberate, but not too deliberate, right? We wanna be more effortless versus like super contrived. Love this hairstyle, really simple, really easy. Here's the before, stick straight, flipped under. Here's the after, half up, flipped up, little volume on either side. You got the poof on the top with some volume and that cute ponytail covered by the hair tie. Super, super easy, super cute. The next youthful hairstyle I want to show you guys is the ponytail. Many of you may think that, you know, over 40, you can't wear a ponytail anymore. I beg to differ. I think you can, and I think it looks fabulous, and I think you should wear a ponytail. I don't know how, you know, I'm going to feel about it in my 60s and 70s. We'll have to check back. I got a few years before that happens. But for now, I'm definitely still wearing the ponytail. So I want to show you a go-to, very quick and easy, but chic, ponytail style that you could try at home. So basically, I'm just going to pull all of the hair back with my hairbrush, make sure it's really smooth, there are no lumps and bumps around the head. Here's where a lot of us may have some bald spots around the root line. You could always use your like powder, your shadow, something to fill that in if you wanted to, but you don't have to. Now, the placement of the pony is up to you, but I really like it a bit higher like this, but you could go more for middle of the head like that if you want. See, I think when I do up higher, I can get more of a poof on the top. Go ahead and put my hair tie in. Now, before I do anything with the hair tie, I'm going to use my fingers, hold this, pull with this hand so that I can get a little volume on the top. It's uneven, so I'm just gonna go back in here and kind of try to fix it. Usually it's uneven. First try, uneven. If you get it first try, man, good for you. Woo, you're killing it. I never do. Then I have to go back in with the fingers again and pull gently, maybe even like strand, you know, kind of section by section till it looks even to me. Once I have a poof that I'm happy with, I'm pretty much done, but I'm gonna go back and do that same effect I just showed you with the half up ponytail with the full ponytail. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pull up my ponytail like this. I'm gonna take a little tiny piece. You only need a tiny piece of hair. Like this one's good because it's short. And then I'm gonna wrap it around the hair tie until I run out of hair. And then ideally I tuck it in to the same hair tie, but underneath the ponytail. Okay, and there you have it. You got like a little cute hair tie cover that's made out of your own hair. It is a thoughtful hairstyle, but again, effortless, right? We don't look too done, too over the top. And I really appreciate that about this hairstyle. And very youthful, very, very youthful. So many of you have asked about how I curl my hair. I did do an IGTV on Instagram, which by the way, I'm over there at Busby Style. If you wanna follow me there, you know, just everyday outfit inspiration and sometimes beauty tutorials. So I did a how I curl my hair on Instagram, but I haven't done one here on YouTube in a while. So I wanna combine this hairstyle with also showing you how I curl my hair. I think it's very youthful and effortless and cool and sexy to have like loose waves. How do you get the loose waves? The first thing is the right tool. So I love the T3 wand. This came as a trio, so I can take the one part of it off and then change it out for a barrel, a different size barrel. But this is the one I use most often, the wand. And I have my heat glove, so I curl my hair with the heat glove. And I do like, when I do these waves, I do like to part in the middle. Ordinarily, I might have clips to kind of clip up some of it and not clip up some of it, but for right now, I'm just gonna show you, this is normally what I do. So I would just take a piece of hair, and instead of like curling all the way to the root, I'll just kind of do this to smooth it out, and then start about 3 inches down at the widest part of the barrel, then wrap it with the heat glove and hold out the end. See my thumb and index finger, I have hair. I don't hold it that long because I don't want really tight curls. I want loose waves. I might hold for like 10 seconds versus 30 if I were doing a tighter curl. I start with one side. I will curl each piece, small piece, away from me. You can alternate direction if you want to. I would just say that with the pieces that are framing your face, that I would definitely do those away from your face versus toward. And the rest of the hair, you know, dealer's choice. You can alternate, you can do them all away, you can do it all toward, however you feel most comfortable. I do one side, then I do the other side. I always leave out pieces. I always go back and get those pieces I missed. They're usually on the underneath part of my hair, which is also the hardest part to curl, by the way, because it's the closest to your neck, but you gotta curl it anyway. So let's take a look. Let's go back to our stick straight, flipped under side part hairdo. And then let's compare that with the middle part, loose waves, sexy, sexy, sexy hairstyle. Which one do you think looks better? Which one do you think looks more youthful? I would say definitely the waves. The nice thing about when you curl your hair too is it doesn't get as greasy as quickly. So generally you can get away with washing it one last day, and it also will traditionally, at least for my hair, stay for at least a couple of days, which is really nice, especially when you're on the go all the time. The last youthful hairstyle I want to show you is full updo that's not a ponytail. First, I want to show you a very slicked back low bun hairstyle with a center part. I actually happen to love this hairstyle. I wear it all the time, but it's definitely not the most youthful hairstyle. If you want to look younger and more youthful, if that's the goal, then I would suggest instead of doing a low bun, I would do more of a high top knot bun. And there are two top knots I want to show you. The first one is more of a sleek option. So if we're going from sleek low bun, maybe you want to just do a sleek high top knot. And the sleek high top knot, you pull all of your hair back to the crown of your head. Then you slowly and very strategically and neatly wrap the hair around and then tuck this underneath. Then I use my hair tie and make sure I wrap it as tight as it'll go. That's two. Okay. And I can pull this out a little bit, but I don't want to pull it out too much because then it gets messy again. Another option for those of you who want to take it a little further and you want a little bit more of a glam youthful updo, instead of that really neat top knot, you're going to fold it around but keep it a bit messier. And you may even want to leave the ends out and then wrap the ponytail around kind of the messy bun. And then you can also pull out pieces, face framing pieces around the side of your head. If you want to, you can curl these little tiny pieces away from the face. Don't go overboard with these little front framing pieces because then it will look too contrived. So right now it sort of looks super messy and cute. You really want to keep it more on the messy side. And I have a chunk here that kind of fell out. So with that, I can either pin it or I can tuck it into the ponytail. Since I don't have a pin, I'm gonna tuck it in. This is very glam, and I would say of all of the hairstyles I've showed you, this is probably the least effortless. It looks a bit more contrived. I would be more in the like sleek top knot category, but I wanted to give you this option of a bit more glam top knot. But if you're going for super effortless and subtle, then I would go with the sleeker version. Here is again the low bun, sleek, middle part. Nothing wrong with it, but we want a slightly more youthful look, so we're gonna go with higher top knot instead. Which style was your favorite? Which one are you gonna try? Do you have any questions about the styles I showed you? They're all pretty easy. I think that if you're pretty handy with a curling iron, then I think that these will be no problem at all. And then most of them you don't even need the curling iron for. They're really simple, really fast, really easy, effortless, modern, chic, and also youthful, which is what we want, right? If you're watching this video, I'm assuming that's what you want. If you guys like this video and you want to see more like it, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Maybe share my channel with one of your friends or one of your Facebook groups. I'd really appreciate that. Also, just wanted to mention tons of freebies. When you sign up for my newsletter, you get Zoom call tips, you get wardrobe basics checklist, closet editing and organizing checklist. You get a capsule wardrobe catalog. Be sure to sign up for my newsletter. The link to subscribe is down in the description box below. Thank you guys so much for watching. You are awesome. I appreciate each and every one of you. I am so grateful for our community of positive, encouraging, empowering, inspiring women. You will notice on this page, there are not a lot of negative comments. I have throughout the years, very strategically, even when there are negative comments, I do not respond in a negative way. I want our community to remain positive and uplifting and safe and empowering and encouraging and inspiring. There is no negativity here, and that is by design. And that, I just want to tell you, is a reflection of you guys. You're all here because you get it. You're with me on the joy train. Wanted to mention that because I think it's really important to say that. You guys are awesome. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.